Mr Swiveller and Sampson Brass looked from Miss Sally to each other in a state of bewilderment, and then, as by one impulse, caught up their hats and rushed out into the street, darting along in the middle of the road and dashing aside all obstructions as though they were running for their lives. It happened that Kit had been running too, though not so fast, and having the start of them by some few minutes, was a good distance ahead. As they were pretty certain of the road he must have taken, however, and kept on at a great pace, they came up with him at the very moment when he had taken breath and was breaking into a run again. "Stop!" cried Sampson, laying his hand on the one shoulder, while Mr Swiveller pounced upon the other. "Not so fast, sir. You're in a hurry?"
"Yes, I am,"
said Kit, looking from one to the other in great surprise.
I can hardly believe it," panted Sampson, "but something of value is missing from the office. I hope you don't know what."
"Know what? Good heaven, Mr Brass!" cried Kit, trembling from head to foot. "You don't suppose—"
"No, no," rejoined Brass quickly. "I don't suppose anything. Don't say I said you did. You'll come back quietly, I hope."
"Of course I will," returned Kit. "Why not?"
"To be sure," said Brass. "Why not? I hope there may turn out to be no why not. If you knew the trouble I've been in this morning through taking your part, Christopher, you'd be sorry for it."
"And I'm sure you'd be sorry for having suspected me, sir," replied Kit. "Come, let us make haste back."
"Certainly," cried Brass. "The quicker the better. Mr Richard, have the goodness, sir, to take that arm. I'll take this one. It's not easy walking three abreast, but under these circumstances it must be done, sir. There's no help for it."